Howdy droogs, Kel back again here, demonstrating different pipe packing methods and talking about why they don't work that well. We're not even talking about why they don't work that well just yet. We will in the future, in a future video. There's reasons why these methods don't work all that great. Here's one I think isn't too bad, actually, on its own. And I just call it the modified air pocket method. It's not quite the air pocket method, but you just grab a pack of tobacco like this in your hand, kind of make a plug out of it, kind of just get it in your pipe. You know, just press it in there. What this does is it leaves this bottom part kind of almost empty. There's some tobacco in there, but you get this bottom part really kind of loose, which is what you want, and then you get this middle part. You know, the middle part is kind of how you want it. A little air in there, a little sponginess. Not too bad. Not great. And doing it with your fingers like this, there's problems with that. One of the problems with using your finger, I'll give you a little preview of what we're going to talk about later on, is when you use your finger to press tobacco like that, you see a little hole divot it makes in there? A little hole, if we can get that on camera, if it'll focus. You're creating what I call pinch points, where the tobacco is kind of pinched together. And that means when the burn gets down to that piece of tobacco, that area of tobacco, it's not going to want to burn very well. It's not going to want to, you know, the eye, there's not enough oxygen there. We're talking about, you know, the triangle of fire, right? Where you've got, you know, need oxygen and fuel in the right quantities, the right mixture to burn properly. When you press tobacco with your fingers, you're automatically creating little pinch points. It's a very uneven thing in there then, you know. You're losing your consistency of the tobacco. If you know what you're doing and you're careful, you can kind of avoid some of that, but you end up with a very inconsistent pack. There's pinch points, some is looser, some is tighter, which is kind of what you want to avoid. But anyway, this kind of air pocket method can be kind of good if you do it right. Later on, when I discuss the Kel method or the methodless method, that's not a bad technique to use if you know what you're doing. You know, if you use the methodless method, it can be a good way to do it. But, you know, anyway, I just thought I'd show it generally what it is. The idea is you're leaving this bottom part, you're unfilled basically in a sense, and you're trying to get a spongy pack in the middle, which can kind of work. Anyway, there you go. But we'll move on now. I want to show the Frank method, which I think is a brilliant method. Combined with my ideas, I think it's even better, but it's a genius method. Aham Frank, I think that's how you pronounce his name, is a genius. You look up the Frank method on YouTube and you'll see it on there. We'll go into more in depth on the methodless method combined with that method too in a later video. Next video, I'll just show you the Frank method though. Here you go. Talk to you later.